In the 1980s and early 90s, an HIV diagnosis was a death sentence. With the development of a cocktail of prescriptions, survival rates skyrocketed. Still, about 50,000 people in the United States are infected with the virus each year. Worldwide, more than 36 million people are living with HIV or AIDS. And one out of every 8 people who is HIV positive doesn't even know it. So how do we stop this epidemic? To me, the first step in stopping HIV is understanding how it works. The scientific community has to know about the inner workings of the virus in order to eventually develop a vaccine or develop better drugs to prevent transmission. As a virologist, I study how HIV replicates and mutates in cells. This mutation rate makes HIV really unique among viruses. It also makes it difficult to predict the usefulness of medication or vaccines. I'm most interested in one tiny step, one that is invisible to the naked eye. When HIV enters a cell, it has to shed its coating in order to start hardwiring itself into the cell. There has been a lot of debate about how and when this uncoating starts. Does it begin immediately? Do the steps occur simultaneously? Or does the uncoating happen over time? Using kidney cells from owl monkeys, who have a natural immunity to HIV infection, my students and I try to answer these questions. I established an experimental technique to dissect the how and when of the uncoating process. Then we were able to delay the uncoating process and prevent replication of the virus. Blocking this step might mean a medicine or vaccine could be developed to prevent HIV, or at least bring us one step closer to a world without HIV.